Europa, 6th largest moon in the solar system, and the 4th largest moon of Jupiter. This alien world is 770 million kilometers away from the Sun, or 5 times further than Earth is from the Sun. Europa is the smoothest object in the solar system, lacking mountains and craters. It is as well the most promising world in the solar system for an alien life. That is because it has an ocean underneath the ice crust that contains likely 3 times the amount of water than all of the oceans on Earth combined. Because Europa's surface was captured to be very flexible and wobbly through tidal forces of other planets, which could only be done if there is a large amount of liquid water. Plus, there were spotted plumes that shoot water over 160 kilometers above the surface. The diameter of Europa is 3,100 kilometers, which is a bit smaller than our moon's, and it has a surface area of over 30 million kilometers square, which is similar to Africa. Now, whenever there is water on Earth, even a bit of it, including on very isolated places such as Antarctica and any other desert, there is life in that bit of water. So Europa with its ocean is pretty promising. Now, there is no light in Europa's ocean since it is covered with ice crust, but still it is possible for life to exist there since the seafloor in Europa is clearly active through tidal forces. So there is enough energy through hydrothermal vents provided for life on Europa. There are also organisms on Earth that survive with no light at the bottom of our oceans. They are usually located by those similar hot vents. So since formation over 4 billion years passed on Europa, there is a good chance that something formed there. Likely a very simple single cell type of life, maybe even something more complex, but nonetheless, those would be the actual aliens, and it would change the way we think of how common life is in the universe. So Europa is in the focus right now, and for a good reason. NASA plans to send an orbiter that will put a lander there by 2020s, named Europa Clipper. We will then see how the surface of Europa looks like. Europa Clipper will come with many instruments attached to it, including a microscope that can maybe spot some traces of dead life on the surface that was shot out by plumes. Still, if we don't find any type of life, we didn't dig deep into the ocean to know for sure. But then, what if we did? We could then send a submarine there. Now, it won't actually happen in the near future, but there have been a lot of missions proposed to create something like that. But what type of submarine would be needed to survive on Europa? Well, first of all, we would need to drill 25 to 30 kilometers below the surface of Europa to even get to the ocean. Keep in mind that the furthest we've gotten Earth was 12 kilometers below, so drilling something more than double that on a world 700 million kilometers away is kinda hard. But with the help of a very good machine such as Cryobot, we could do it. Cryobot is a robot that can drill water ice with much less power than a drill by melting and sinking into the ice, and does it very well, as it demonstrated, going a few times over 1,000 meters under ice on Greenland expedition. But since it is minus 220 Celsius on average on Europa, there will be a lot of problems. So still, technology is kinda there, we just need to improve a lot on it to drill such a hole. The next part is sending a submarine down that hole, which could be achieved by slowly ascending the submarine. It wouldn't as well need to be very large, just good enough to capture the environment. But we want a submarine down to the seafloor to really know if there is any life. So first we have to realize how great the pressure is down there. So the deepest spot on Earth, Mariana Trench, is about 12 kilometers deep, and the average depth of Europa's seafloor should be about 100 kilometers, or 8 times more than the deepest spot on Earth. And the pressure at the bottom of Europa's seafloor is at least 10,000 times more than the pressure on the surface of Earth. So this means that the submarine would have to survive with 100 kilometers of water stacked up upon it. That should be a few million kilograms pushing onto the submarine. Now, creating a submarine that could survive such pressure is pretty hard. It would need to be made out of very different materials. It would probably be one of the strongest things humanity has made, and it would have a very limited time of running under Europa's ocean. Since, unlike Martian rovers, there is no sunlight that would propel the submarine through solar panels. But just maybe it could possibly transform that heat from those hydrothermal vents into energy to propel the submarine. It would as well need to power a very powerful artificial light to capture Europa's seafloor nicely. Now, if it finds any life, including microscopic, it sure would be tougher than any organism on Earth, because surviving that pressure is extreme. Even one of the toughest organisms on Earth, tardigrades or water bears, cannot survive that pressure. Certain species of tardigrades can survive 6,000 bars, but this is 10,000 bars, even deeper. Still, to get all these instruments successfully to Europa and for them to work properly requires a lot of power, and a lot of technical obstacles are in the way. So, in reality, this mission could maybe be possible in the future, but for now we are just not that technologically advanced, but thankfully we have a lot to look forward to. Europa Clipper is definitely one of the most exciting missions in the near future. Amazing discoveries are awaiting us.